Good morning, Jacobsville families. We are here at the Horton household bringing you today's children's message. I have Amos and Mackenzie here. You can't see them right now, but you will in a couple minutes as they're going to help me out with some of our activities today. So, really quick, you might be watching this with your moms or dads. And if you are, kids, I need you to go ask your mom and moms, do earmuffs. Okay, so this is earmuffs. Ask them to cover their ears because I want to just talk to you really quick about something. Or maybe you're watching it with your grandma or someone special in your life. So just ask them to go earmuffs. Okay, I'll give you a second. Okay, now I'm going to kind of whisper because I don't want them to hear. But in case you didn't know, today, this Sunday, is Mother's Day. All right? It's Mother's Day. I'm pretty sure you guys already knew that, but just in case you didn't know, today is Mother's Day. All right? So, what I want you to do is to draw some flowers. You can make a garden scene. You can just draw a couple flowers. You can draw a bouquet of flowers, a vase of flowers, any type of flowers. And I want you to draw those when we're done with our message today and give them to someone special. Maybe you don't have a mom that you're living with right now. Maybe you're living with your grandma or your aunt or someone special. Or maybe you've already done something for your mom. And you could give this to someone else. It could even be someone at church or someone, a female, a mom figure in your life. You could even do that, and that would make their day so awesome, okay? So after the message today, let's do that, okay? All right, now you can go tell your moms that they can take their earmuffs off and listen, okay? So we already know what our special thing is right after. Okay, cool. All right, so today we're going to do a little activity. So what I need you to get is a piece of paper and something to write with. It could be a pen, a crayon, a pencil, marker, whatever your parents want you to write with. And you might be saying, I'm a little young. I don't really know how to write my letters or anything like that. Totally fine. You can say them. Okay. You can use just verbally say some of these things or think them in your head. Okay. So if you can't write them down, that's fine. You can still do this too, okay? All right, so we're talking about fruit today, all right? And so what I need you to do is on your piece of paper, you can pause it if you still haven't gotten it yet, but on your piece of paper, in 60 seconds, I'm gonna time you, I want you to write as many types of fruit as you can think of. Any fruit, in 60 seconds, I'm gonna time you, all right? And let me get my timer set here. All right, 60 seconds and go. Having a hard time?
I can't write it.
Okay, 30 seconds, halfway there, 30 seconds. Good job. All right, so now we got our fruits down, okay? Now we're gonna do something different. We're gonna categorize them, okay? Categorize them. So that means you're gonna group them in similar groups, okay? So we're gonna have a group of fruits that have seeds in them. So you're gonna write any type of fruit that have a seed, and then a group that you peel. So any type of fruit that you listed that you peel. And then if you have fruits that don't fit into either of those, You can make just an oddball list, right? An other list, okay? Are you guys ready? Should we do 60 seconds, do you think, or 30 seconds?
60.
You want 60 seconds? Okay, so remember, seeds, fruit that have seeds that you listed.
So write the categories.
Yep. Out of your list, fruits that have seeds, fruits that you peel to eat, and then just oddball ones. Okay?
Here.
Ready?
No.
Go.
Oh, man.
Stop it us. Yeah, we're just getting started. Blasting right to the top. Making that needle drop. Do you that roll your crown? Tell everyone that it's down. No time to play it safe. We'll set the record straight. This is our walk up song. Everyone's gonna sing along.
All right, 30 seconds, halfway there. You guys are doing good. This is a little trickier. Fruits that have seeds, fruits that you peel to eat, and an oddball list. All right, 10 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right. Good job, guys. Oh.
Oh, I did it.
Okay. All right. I want to hear what is one of the fruits you wrote down that is has a seed in it.
Strawberry.
Okay, Kenzie?
Oranges.
That has a seed? Oh, oranges, yep. Okay, what is one fruit that you peel?
A banana.
Yep,
and then an orange again.
Okay, and do you have any oddball ones?
Apple.
I have a pear.
Okay.
And grapes.
You, those do all have seeds in them.
What?
That's okay. All right, what is your favorite fruit that you eat?
Grapes.
Grapes for Amos?
Cherries.
Cherries? Good. Okay, good job, guys. You can put your pencils down and your papers away for right now, and we will move on to the next thing.
All right, so you may be wondering why we're talking about fruit, okay? Well, our story today is in the Bible, and it is about fruit. But do we think it's about eating fruit? Fruit is good for our bodies, right? I have a whole bowl of fruit here. We have an orange, an apple, pear, and a banana, okay? When we eat fruit, what does it do for our bodies? An orange, for instance, when you eat an orange, I know this is a clementine, but for the sake of today, it's an orange. It gives us vitamin C, right? And vitamin C helps us stay healthy. It helps us take sickness away. Just like when we eat an apple, right, we get good nutrients out of an apple to keep our bodies healthy and strong. How many of you guys have heard an apple a day keeps the doctor away? Anyone? You may have to ask your mom and dads because this is an old saying. So kids, you may be a little confused by it. But your moms and dads have heard it. Trust me. All right. So we're talking about fruit today. And it's not about fruit that we eat, but it's called the fruit of the Spirit. Does anyone know what the term fruit of the Spirit means? Well, my hope is that after today, you will know, okay? Fruit of the Spirit. Our story today is found in Galatians. That is in the New Testament of our Bibles. I got my Bible right here. Chapter 5, all right? And we are talking about fruits of the Spirit. And the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, and self-control. All right? So when we talk about fruits of the Spirit, these are gifts from God. These are gifts from the Holy Spirit. And these seeds, we talked about fruit that have seeds in them. So apples, can we all agree that apples have seeds in them, right? So it takes a seed to grow, to be planted and to grow into something, right? So these seeds, God grows inside of us to show us what his love looks like. And we're talking about the way we act when we put our faith in Jesus. We ask him to forgive us of our sins, and we promise to be his followers. And the Bible tells us that when we do that, the Holy Spirit fills us with God's love and produces the good fruit in our life. And that good fruit is for us to show God's love to those around us, okay? Let me ask you this. If you were hungry, and let's say maybe some of you guys have apple trees in your backyard, and maybe if you don't, that let's pretend you do, and you were hungry and you want to go pick an apple, okay? So you go to the apple tree and you reach up and you pick and you're like, it's broccoli. And you're like, what? Why is there broccoli? I wanted an apple. What's going on here? Okay? It's kind of the same. When we think about when God fills, the Holy Spirit fills us and plants these seeds into our life, right? We grow into these fruits of the Spirit. That's what God wants to see in our lives. He wants to see those and nourish and grow, all right? So when you go to an apple tree, you expect to pick an apple, right? Okay? So we have love, we have joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. I counted 9. These are all things that Jesus modeled for us to show us what it looks like to show love and to have joy and to be patient and to be gentle. Jesus' ministry on earth in the New Testament, he was perfect, right? He was sinless. So these are all modeled for us in Jesus' ministry and life on this earth. And he did that to show us, to be the example of what it should look like to be filled with the Spirit, right? To be a believer and follower of Jesus and to show other people, the world around us, the love of Jesus, right? So the awesome thing is, again, that when we deny ourselves and accept Jesus to be the Savior of our life, to be the Lord of our lives, God brings the Holy Spirit to fill us and to plant the seeds and they begin to grow. Okay? Now, I want you to think about this. What would it look like in your life to have these fruits of the Spirit? Are you patient when you have to wait in line, maybe? Are you patient when maybe you don't get to be the first person in the line? Are you quick to try to run in front? Are you patient as you wait? Maybe are you patient when you're really, really hungry for dinner and your mom's trying to get it going? Are you patient? Now, I'm not saying it's easy, because guess what? I struggle being patient too. You can probably even ask your moms and dads if they struggle with being patient. Sometimes, especially when you're driving a car, it's hard to be patient. All right, what about, do you show love to people when it's maybe not easy to show love to them? What about a sibling or a friend that took a toy out of your hands? Is it hard to show them kindness and love? I know it's hard for me to do it. If someone wasn't nice to me, maybe it's hard to show kindness to them. Are you always gentle and kind to your family members? I know right now, right, we're all kind of stuck inside. And it's hard. It's not easy, right? There's going to be times that you're going to fail. But when you do fail, you can ask God to forgive you, and you can ask that he will fill you with his Spirit and to produce these kinds of fruit that he wants to see in your life. Okay? So again, let's read. I'm going to read to you Galatians chapter 5, and we will read verse 22 and 23. But the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, self-control. Against such things there is no law. And those who belong in Christ Jesus have crucified the flesh with its passions and desires. All right. So this week, I would love for you guys to think about, as you're just living your life, right, to ask God to help you to be filled with the Spirit, to be filled with love and joy and peace and patience and kindness and goodness and self-control. Again, it's not easy, and we are going to fail. But when we do fail, we can ask God to forgive us and ask the Spirit to fill us with those seeds and be planted. And it's important, too, that we nourish these, right? If you had an apple seed and you planted it in the ground and you just walked away from it and didn't ever go back, is it going to grow? It's not. So we need to water it, right? We need to take care of it, just like we need to do ourselves. We need to be reading God's word. We need to be worshiping him through acts of worship, right? Reading the word, praying, okay? Praising God for all he has done for us. All right, now, I am done with my message, but I have a song that is talking about the fruit of the Spirit that I think you guys will enjoy. It's kind of silly, but it's fun. My kids really liked it, and it kind of gets stuck in your head. So that's the point. I want you guys to remember what the fruit of the Spirit is, what they are, and how we can continue to nourish them in our life, okay? And also, do not forget that we have a little project to do. Remember, we talked about it at the beginning of our message, okay? So go ahead and do that. And I really hope that we get to see each other face to face very soon. I am praying that the Lord would allow this virus to leave and that we can go back to worshiping at church together. And I really miss seeing your smiling faces. You guys are a blessing to me. And I hope you guys have a great rest of your week. And happy Mother's Day to all the moms out there and the moms that help at our church that maybe don't have children of their own, but they have adopted children in our church by loving them and caring for them. We appreciate each and every one of you at Jacob's Well, and we are thankful to God for you. All right, have a great week.